Hi, it's Allan Share with the Spa Industry Association. I am here today with my longtime friend and fellow wine lover, Mark Wuttke. He's president and CEO of Babor America. How are you doing, my friend?
Fantastic, Allan. Fantastic to be here with you today.
As you know, I love everything about Babor, and I'm glad your team keeps me in ampules. You can talk about that if you want. But you and I always go into a lot of other conversations along the way. And I think they're always interesting. And I hope in this two or three part series, we can just share a few of the things that we both find interesting with our audience. You and I talk a lot about communications, how everyone communicates, but few seem to connect. Do you want to address that a little bit for us?
Yeah, very much so. Evidence has shown that each day we're probably trying to understand about 34, 35,000 different messages, which means we're absolutely being inundated by information. So there's a lot of communication out there, but how do you actually make a connection through it? So what are the filters? How do we actually distill that down and grab the gold nuggets that are in the 34,000 messages and take it somewhere? And the reason why it's important, because people who communicate and then connect actually have influence, because effective communication, which is the connection, is part of leadership. And leadership is influence. So if we want to have a positive influence of someone, we really need to work out how to connect with those individuals.
You know, I like a number of things you just said, but absolutely positive influence. It seems there's so much negative media today, although I am heartened by the things I've watched go on in Texas and how people have supported people without being asked, which is pretty amazing. But that ability to be positive, not only with yourself, but with people is critical, right? To mostly for building a good team in your company.
Yeah. In fact, it's a very good example that you just used, because true connection is nothing about yourself. It's all about the other people. And, you know, one is not a big number of greatness. And everything we do in life, if we do it with other people, not only is it more fulfilling, it actually just has so much more impact in regards to the further you can involve other people in this outreach on some of the natural disasters that we've seen. This is the true reflection of the human spirit, and it's going far beyond communication. This is true connection back with our fellow human beings.
I love it. Mark, you addressed the 35,000 times a day that we're kind of getting tapped in our, do people read anymore in your estimation, or what, when you want to communicate, is it short and tight? Can you address that a little bit?
I think people do read. I think people do listen. But I think the most important thing is, what is the filter? So, and it goes back one step. In my belief, we need to determine what's important to us and what our values are as early as possible, because then that helps us diffuse and clarify the information. Because that what happens then is, once we understand what's important to us, we catch those nuggets that go spinning past us or don't get past us. You can let a lot of it go by. You don't need it if it's not important to you. And you see the people who understand that can make decisions really quickly. You find the people who don't know what they want, don't know what they're looking for, and then, you know, when you try to be everything to everyone, you become nothing to everyone.
You know, you used another one of my favorite words, which is clarity. And clarity fits in extremely well with the being of a good listener and all the positive energy. Clarity is something I do time and time again, is always say, am I addressing your concern? Am I answering your question? Those things are important, right, to make sure the other party's understanding.
Yeah, it's critical. In fact, the real answer, I believe, is often in the question, not in the talk. And because if you ask smart questions, you not only are showing the people you're connected with them because you listen to them, but then you're actually solving a problem for them, right? Too many people, I think, come into our environment wanting to sell something to someone, and that could end up being buyer's remorse if that was never a need for that person. So understanding their expectations, trying to understand what they're looking for, and then becoming a solution-based person. the selling of anything becomes incredibly simple and easy if you are meeting and or exceeding the person's expectations. But if you don't ask the question, how will you ever know it?
Easier to get everyone on the right side of the table. Mm-hmm. Mark, you say there are four or five or six different connecting strengths. Mm-hmm. Can you address a couple of those for us?
Yeah. In my personal belief, I think there's a half a dozen, five really critical strengths. I never have a problem laughing at myself. I often think you might as well laugh at yourself because everyone else is. So I might as well get off the bat. I love laughing at myself because I think it gives an element of humility to who you're actually communicating with. But once again, not just humor for humor's sake. Usually it's a story which is humorous, but it's making a point. I also think authenticity is absolutely crucial. I think leaders of tomorrow, it's not about a role. It's not about being perfect and perfectionism. It's about authenticity. All of us, you know, and my definition of authenticity is thinking, feeling, and acting as one. No incongruence. I think there's the side of me on my left, which is all the things which I'm not proud of in my life, which often make me look a little bit worse than I really am. Then there's the stuff on the right, which is all my successes, which often magnify and exaggerate really how great I am. And I just try to walk somewhere down that middle, somewhere down the middle between my failures, my disappointments, and my successes, and it just keeps me grounded. Confidence, I think it's absolutely crucial when it comes to confidence. Once you know what you want and you actually go for that, I think that really, really helps because that's what gives you that clarity that you want, and then you can act with confidence. Hope, I actually think hope is something everyone's looking for every single day. If you don't see hope, what does your future like? And I've always said, and I firmly believe this, you know, we only have today. Yesterday's gone. We don't even know if tomorrow's going to be here. So today is what really matters. And I look at each day is that we are either preparing for a fantastic tomorrow or we're repairing what we actually didn't do yesterday.
Love it. Well said. Mark, can you teach?
I forgot one thing there, Allan, actually.
Oh, which one?
Just come to me. Simplicity. I think part of communication is absolutely, and connecting is simplicity. Too many times we actually try to sound impressive using words that are overly impressive and to impress, but that's all about making myself look good. That's not about actually finding out what station the person is on and actually communicating exactly and connecting at the level where they're at.
I like the first three letters of KISS. Keep it simple. We don't need the last letter. Just keep it simple, right? People understand.
I resemble the last one.
Okay. I was asking you about effective connecting. It can be learned, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's one of the beautiful things about it because it's about intentionality and it's about consciousness in regards to that. You know, often talent is rarely enough, right? If you can have all the talent in the world or natural talent, but if you're not conscious in regards to it, and by the consciousness, you can actually start to teach yourself. If you're listening, you're looking at the results and then taking time to think about, well, if I would have gone a different route, how could that influence the different outcome? And quite often it's in the questions you ask.
Right.
I think it's one of the most critical things anyone can learn, particularly if you're in leadership and you're a position of influence.
And as salespeople, we forget sometimes that asking the good questions is part one. You need to listen.
Yeah, tell me about it. I often tell my sales team, and when I work with them, you know, when you're telling, you're not selling.
When you're telling, yeah, well said. Okay, give me a good takeaway. Effectively connecting with people. What's the number one thing you would say if someone wanted to start today doing something different, what do they do to change?
Take yourself out of the picture. It's nothing to do with you, and it's all about the person you're connecting with. When you surrender your heart and you surrender yourself to serving that person that you're with, you're not thinking about what's in it for me. You're thinking about how can I add value to this individual? And by doing that, I think you'll see a remarkable change in the results that you achieve because people are all talking over the top of each other, but very few people are connecting.
That's well said. In fact, it's very prescient. Can I use a word like that?
I think we can use whatever words we want, mate.
I think you nailed it right on the head. And this serving doesn't even have to be in a religious sense. It can. You're just talking about mano-mano, right? It's good to serve other people. And it should make you feel good, too.
Yeah, well, you know, I've been in a senior leadership role for a long time now, Allan, much more than sometimes I want to admit. With responsibility and leadership, it's not about a title. Your responsibility increases with that because you have greater influence over people. Also, your decisions are dramatically impacting the people around you. And as a leader, if you don't take that into consideration and lean in, get close to these people and have that serving attitude, leadership is actually, it's the way you behave. It's what you earn. It's not a title. And I think that's what I've learned the most about it. And, you know, don't get me wrong. I'm no saint with this. I've made massive errors in my life, but it's the reflection on those errors. And when I've fallen down, I sometimes stay down on the ground a little bit longer, Allan, and think about why am I down here? Because it's when I do the reflection while I'm down on the ground, and if I've lost a bit of skin off my knees, that's when I learn. When I fall and I jump straight up, wipe myself off, look around and hope no one was looking at me, that's when I make the mistake again.
Well, I'm going to end this with my father-in-law, who's long passed but was a strong mentor of mine, used to say, it's okay to get knocked down, but contemplate it and get up and get back in the game.
Yeah. You know right? What, Allan, on the weekend, I saw Bonnie St. John, the Olympic athlete, win a transformational leadership award. And that lady was the one without a leg who was the first African-American lady to win a medal at the Winter Olympic Games. She went down the hill the first time in that Olympic Games and had a world record time. The second time she went down, when it was actually in the finals, the one who won the gold medal fell down and she also fell down. The reality, she was the fastest down that hill. But the one who got the gold medal was the faster getter-upper. And I think that's the big thing in life. And you just reminded me of that when I just heard you say that. And sorry, I just had to put it in because I've met Bonnie St. John twice now, and she's one of the most transformational, innovative, and inspiring leaders that I've come across.
Mark, this has been the best 10 minutes of my week. Thank you for sharing with us. I appreciate it. And we were going to look forward to seeing you in Florida and in Vegas and a bunch of other things along the way, other places.
You certainly will, my friend. And I look forward to finally sharing a few notes on some of our red wine opportunities that come before us.
Agreed. Thank you very much.
Cheers, my friend. Thank you.